Okay, so in this video, we're going to be taking a look at rounding decimals to significant figures. If you want to check out any of my other rounding videos before carrying on with this one, I'll leave some links for them in the description, and I'll also put the card in the top corner. So for this first question, we want to round 5,321.4 to one significant figure. So to find that first significant figure, we're looking for that first digit that isn't a zero. So in this first example, our first significant figure would be the 5. So now because we're rounding to one significant figure, all we're going to do is put our line down between the 5 and the 3. So now we follow our rounding rule. If the digit on the right of the line we've just drawn is 5 or more, then we're going to round up the previous digit. And if it's less than 5, we're going to keep the previous digit the same. So we look to the right of our line and we've got a 3. So because it's less than 5, it means we're going to keep the previous digit, which was the 5, the same. So the 5 is going to stay the same, so I'm just going to write that underneath. Like so. And then I need a placeholder in all the other columns. So under the 3, I'm going to have a 0. Under the 2, a 0. And under the 1, another 0. We can then put our decimal point in and technically put another 0 in our tenths column below the 4. But we can just stop when we get to that decimal point. So 5,321.4 rounded to one significant figure would be 5,000. Okay, and we're rounding to one significant figure again for this next question. So our first significant figure in this number, again, would be the first digit that isn't a zero. So our first significant figure would actually be the 8. So now that we've found that, we're going to draw a line between that 8 and the next digit, which in this case is a 3. So now we want to determine whether the 8 will stay as an 8 or round up to a 9. And to do that, we use our rounding rule again. We look at the digit on the right of the line, which in this case is a 3. So because it's a 3, that means we're going to keep the previous digit the same, so the 8 will remain as an 8. So all I need to do now is copy these numbers on the left-hand side of the line, so 0 below the 0, 0.0, and the 8 remained as an 8. So that number there, rounded to one significant figure, would be 0.08. Okay, moving on, we now went around these to two significant figures. So to round to two significant figures again, we want to find our first significant figure by finding our first non-zero digit, which in this first example would be the 4, and then we just move left to right. So if 4 is my first significant figure, 2 would be my second significant figure. So now I'm going to draw my line down, and it goes through the decimal point on this one. So now we follow our rounding rule again, and we want to see whether the 2 on the left-hand side of the line remains as a 2, or we'll round up to a 3. So again, to do that, we look on the right-hand side of that line and we've got a 6. So because it's 5 or more, we're going to round up the previous digit. So the 2 will actually round up to a 3. So we copy our number down on the left-hand side. We had our 4. And then the 2 rounded up to a 3. And again, we could technically fill in our placeholders here. So we'd have our decimal points and then we'd have 0, 0 below these other two digits. But because I've reached my decimal point, we can just say it's 43. So 42.64 rounded to two significant figures would be 43. And for this next example, again, rounded to two significant figures. Again, our first significant figure would be our first non-zero digit, which would be 3. So 3 would be the first significant figure, meaning 1 would be the second significant figure. So once we've done that, we draw our line. And we now want to determine whether the 1 will stay as a 1 or round up to a 2. So to do that, we look to the right-hand side of our line. We have an 8, so that means we're going to round up the previous digit. So I'm going to copy this number underneath again. We've got a 0.3, and then the 1 rounded up to a 2. And once we've reached that point, we can stop there, because again, we could put our placeholders in of zeros, but we don't need to in this case when we have our decimal. So our final answer to this one would just be 0.32. So hopefully that method made sense. We're now going to look at a few more practice questions. Okay, so feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for these first couple of questions, we want to round to one significant figure. So to find that first significant figure, we're going to look for that first non-zero digit, which in this first example would be 4. We're then going to draw our line between this and the next digit, which is at an 8. So now we want to determine whether that 4 will stay as a 4 or round up to a 5. But we look on the digit at the right of our line, which is an 8. Because it's an 8, we're going to round up the 4 to a 5. So I'm going to write underneath in the same columns, we've got our 0.0, and then our 4 rounds up to a 5. So we can stop there. So the answer to that first one is 0.05. Okay, for this next example, round into one significant figure again. Well, the first significant figure in this number would be the 3. So we then draw our line, and we look at that digit to the right of the line. So because it's a 2, that means we're going to keep the 3 as a 3. So we copy our digits underneath, so we have 0.00, and the 3 remains as a 3. So that'll be our answer to that one. For these next examples, we want to round to two significant figures. So for this first one, 3 would be my first significant figure, meaning 7 would be my second significant figure. So once I've done that, I'm going to draw my line straight down. And then on the right-hand side of the line, we have an 8. So because it's an 8, that means we're going to round up the previous digit. So the 7 on the left of the line will round up to an 8. So writing underneath, we've got 0.3, and the 7 has rounded up to an 8. So that would be 0.38. Moving on again to two significant figures, we'd have 4 as our first and 7 as our second significant figure. So we draw our line down again, and we look at the digit on the right of this line, which is a 1. So because it's a 1, that means we're going to keep the previous digit the same, so the 7 will remain as a 7. So writing again underneath, we've got 0.04, and the 7 remains. So that'd be the answer to that one. And then for these final few examples, we want to round to three significant figures. So for this first example, our first significant figure, again, would be our first non-zero digit, which would be our 8, meaning 9 would be our second significant figure. And then this 0 would be the third significant figure as we move left to right. So I then draw my line straight down, and then I look at this digit on the right of the line. So because we've got a 5, that means we're going to round the previous digit up. So the 0 would actually round up to a 1. So now we're going to copy these digits down again. So we've got 0.089, and the 0 has rounded up to a 1. So that would be my answer to that one. And for this very final example, again, rounding to three significant figures. Well, we're looking for our first significant figure. That would be the 7, which means 8 would be our second significant figure, and then 1 would be our third significant figure. So once we found them, we then draw our line, and we focus on this digit on the right-hand side of the line. So because it's a 4, that means we're going to keep the previous digit the same, so the 1 will remain as a 1. So here I'm just going to have 0.0078, and the 1 remains as a 1. And that'd be my final answer to that one. So hopefully that made sense, and that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.